The question, can you write a short story about your deepest fear? It was a storm like no other. The flashing rip of lightning sizzled across the sky and the pounding drums of thunder reverberated through the air. The sea churned and tumbled, spitting up thick rolls of beige foam. The throbbing cadence of water and thunder matched that of the wallowing boat being tossed upon the wrathful waves. A short scream cut even shorter by a silent splash, the smack lost in the noisome world. The body thrashed in the water, flipping and jerking like a marionette dictated by a cruel puppeteer. A flash of jagged electricity illuminated the water long enough to see the body slow, and in the next flash, it was still, suspended, limbs and hair floating angelic in the green depths. Inside the body there was a keening scream, a crushing pain of breath unreleased. The motionless limbs felt like they were compressed within sleeves of needles, stabbing and prickling. Yet numb, sight flickered to a final reddish black before fading to utter darkness. With a silent cry of desperation, lips opened to release the burning air. Water rushed to replace it, filling empty lungs with agony. The body twitched, and then began to float upward. It bobbed to the surface where it was thrashed about by the cruel waves. Death would not be a sweet, graceful release. Not this time. Drowning is often portrayed as a beautiful death, peaceful once acceptance takes over. It is not. It is agonizing, petrifying, and utterly paralyzing. It takes complete control. Ever since my own drowning and subsequent resuscitation, I have been haunted by night terrors and a ruthless fear of water.